Hello, my name is Imkozin. I'm from FIU, and let me talk you through this flash talk, which talks about two diffractive exclusive processes that we looked at in the context of the electron ion collider. Right, so these are the two processes that we're looking at. In both cases, there's a diffractive row production, so at the same rapidity as the virtual photon, and then separated by a large rapidity gap, you have an exclusive process happening on the nucleon. So the top diagram is the first process we looked at is dileptum production. So this is similar to time-like Compton scattering. And in the bottom, it's an additional meson being produced on the nucleon. So you have sufficient hard scales in both these diagrams to ensure that you have both a small size dipole here at the top and a GPD description in at the bottom. Because the exchange between the top and the bottom part of these diagrams happens through a Pomeron, there is no gluon contributions in the GPD diagram, only quarks coupled to it. Other interesting features are that the cross-section is independent of the total invariant mass of the cross-section, so of the virtual photon nucleon system, and that we probe the ARBL region of the GPD, so where X is smaller than the skewness Xi. But over here in the two vector, in the two meson process, you can actually also probe transversity by detecting a transversely polarized meson in the bottom part of the diagram. All right, so we did a study for EIC kinematics. We looked at different perturbative inputs, so non-perturbative inputs, so different GPD models, interface to partner, different distribution amplitudes for the mesons. And we looked at different meson channels, proton, neutron targets. I'll only show a small selection here. So first is the dileptin production process, where we plot things as a function of femtobarn. So here, this is the virtuality of the incoming, and on the x-axis, the virtuality of the outgoing photon. And then you do see that we get very small cross-sections unless you go to quite low virtualities, right, where the model isn't supposed to work. So this does not look too promising right now. On the other hand, the two meson production process does look promising. So here it's plotted as nanobarn for a bunch of different GPD models and distribution amplitudes. And I picked one particular case, so transversely polarized rho and omega vector mesons. So this would probe transversely GPDs, where you do see that the different models give different predictions. All right, so I showed you some results for two diffractive exclusive processes where we are able to discriminate between different GPD models. Dileptin process rates look too low at the moment. The two meson case looks more promising. There are, however, theory extensions that could increase the size of the cross-section, especially including BFKL corrections for the Pomeron. And we also have full simulations planned for the EIC detectors. Here are some references if you want to find out more. Thank you.